teaching on victory over the wiles of the devil. This should be the part three of that teaching, victory over the wiles of the devil. And we'll be looking on inquiry, why it's important, very important, that we hear from God. Why it is to our own advantage that we truly hear the voice of God in our lives, that we truly encounter God in such a mighty way, and that we are led intuitively by His instructions. And if you're going to make it, if you're going to acquire or accomplish anything with God, it is so important that you hear from God, that the reality of God's word is in you. You are able to hear what God is saying. You're able to understand what God has said. And you know exactly what God wants you to accomplish and what God wants you to do. God has the ability to change your situations. Yes, there are those that God has called in ministry into the family of His grace, and yet they don't inquire of Him. They are like King Ahab, who goes to war without asking for God's clarity and God's direction. Whenever you inquire of God, God speaks. Many have come to premature death, be it ministers, irrespective of anointing, grace, and mercy of God, because they did not inquire or inquire of God concerning what they were getting themselves into. We find a tragic story in 1 Kings chapter 22, verse 7 and 8 and onward, that Ahab called Jehoshaphat to go to war with him. And as they went to that war, Jehoshaphat was not convinced that the prophets that Ahab had around him were accurate. In those days, you need a prophet to consult with God, as the king's role was limited. But in the New Testament, we have liberty, we have freedom. We can connect with God. We can move with God. We can appreciate God. So Jehoshaphat said in 1 Kings 22 verse 7, and Jehoshaphat said, is there not still a prophet of the Lord here that we may inquire of him? So the king of Israel said unto Jehoshaphat, there is still one man, Micah, the son of Imala, by whom we may inquire of the Lord. But I hate him, because he does not prophesy good concerning me, but evil. And Jehoshaphat said, let not the king say such things. Sometimes when you inquire of God, you must be willing to listen to the truth. The reason most people don't appreciate what God tells them is because they want to do what they predisposed to do, what they've planned already to do. So when God says something, you're like, hold on. No, I don't want to do that. If you want to inquire of God, you must make sure you're obedient to the word of God. For if you inquire of God and your heart is not in it, God will not speak to you. God cannot be mocked. That's what the Bible says. When God speaks to you the first time, the second time, and there's no third time, because your heart is not ready to hear the truth. Often what God says to us is not what will make you feel jolly, fleshly good. Sometimes God will speak to you to do certain things that on the physical sense, it makes no sense to you yet, because it makes no sense. Tonight, that's why, you see, hearing from God entails an obedient and willing heart. Your heart must be yielded. You must be willing to obey God. So when you come to inquire of God, you must have a ready spirit. That was the beauty of David. That was separate David from all his children and all his descendants. It was he had a willing heart to obey God. That's why God says, I have found a man after my heart. God's heart is not rigid. God's heart is not, that's why God is always willing. When a sinner repents, no matter the crime he has done, God forgives him or her. You and I get offended. What? You know about the testimony of General Butt Naked from Liberia. I mean, that YouTube video, if you've not seen it, just type the testimony of General Butt Naked from Liberia. All the atrocity that this man did, all the evil and wickedness, killing humans every day for rituals, taking their heart, eating their heart, all the wickedness he did, the minute he repents and comes to Christ, in fact, God went for him. God, the love of God went to get him. The love of God went after him. It's amazing, eh? God went to rescue him and saved him. Used his servant to minister to him. And today that guy is a dynamic preacher. That individual is a dynamic preacher. That individual is a dynamic preacher. Today, that individual is a dynamic preacher. It shows you what the saving grace of God can do. It tells you what the power and the mercy of God can do in a man. But our heart must be willing and yielded to Christ. We must be willing to do whatever he says for us to do. God wants you to come to him, to seek him. God wants to speak. He wants to speak to you. And in that battle, Ahab died because he did not listen to God. He did not listen to the true prophet. We find in another instance in the book of 2 Kings chapter 1 verse 3. And this is a mistake that most people make. Most of you, you've trespassed on these things. You want to consult mediums because you don't know what God is going to say. Oh yes, there's so many Christians, they pray on the prayer line, they preach, whereas they'll send money back to Africa to their family members and say, well, go consult that man, that witch doctor on my behalf. Don't tell him it's me. I say there's somebody that is sick. There's somebody you know that's having this problem. Let him send you something to you, then you post it to me. We have a similar situation in the Bible of a king like that. in the book of 2 Kings chapter 1 verse 16. In 2 Kings chapter 1, you find that there was this king who was sick. And he did not consult God. 2 Kings chapter 1. King Ahaziah. He was once a good king. But he was the son of Ahab. Ahab had that generational inheritance of not really willing to consult with God. The Bible says in 2 Kings chapter 1. Moab rebelled against Israel after Ahab's death. Now Ahaziah fell through the lattice of his upper room in Samaria. He was resting on the porch and he fell and was injured. He was injured. So he sent messengers and said to them, "Go inquire of Beelzebub," that's a demonic god, "the god of Ekron, whether I shall recover from this injury." You see, he was seeking soothsayers, occult, to inquire of for. You can't be a child of God and call on my father. And when you have problems you think are too difficult, you look for a voodoo priest to consult with, or a psych, or a fortune teller. You go to fortune tellers, palm readers. Oh yes, so many Christians in America do that. Oh, they sneak into those places, pay $50, $25, whatever, and the woman reads their palm. Or the African witch doctors in New York or Florida read their palms for them. Or they don't have a hotline, say, "Call this number." You can't do such things and expect God to hear you. But the angel of the Lord said to Elijah the Tishbat, "Arise, go up to meet the messenger of the king of Samaria and say to them, is it because there is no God in Israel that you are going to inquire of Beelzebub, the god of Ekron? Now therefore, thus says the Lord, you shall not come down from the bed to which you have gone up, but you shall surely die." So Elijah departed. Yeah. God will not be humiliated by your worries and fears. You can't humiliate God. You can't humiliate God. In verse 16, it says, "Then he said to him, thus says the Lord, because you have sent messengers to inquire of Beelzebub, the god of Ekron, is it because there's no God in Israel to inquire of his word? Therefore, you shall not come down, but you shall surely die." You cannot put God in your reserve seat. In the times of crisis, you need to inquire of him, for God can be found. God is not hidden from us. God is not hidden from you. God can be found. God can be found. We found the problem again. We find in another situation that Jehoshaphat now was with another king again. In 2 Kings chapter 3 verse 11. There was a time there were problems with Edom of Moab again, and Jehoshaphat, Ahab, and another king, they went again and they missed their way. And Ahab said, "Oh, God wants to kill us in the wilderness. God brought us here to destroy us, blah blah blah." The Bible said, but Jehoshaphat said, 2 Kings chapter 3 verse 11, "Is there no prophet of the Lord here that we may inquire of the Lord by him?" So one of the servants of the king of Israel answered and said, Elisha, the son of Shaphat, is here, who poured water on the hands of Elijah. Now understand, if you look at verse 17, they were in the desert. And it seems an impossible situation. And it seems an impossible feat. How can water come from the desert? Here is the power of miracle. When you know how to inquire of the Lord, God knows how to reverse the irreversible in your life. Masakoto. Woo, Jesus. When you know how to inquire of the Lord, when you choose to inquire of the Lord, God himself will see to it that there is miracle in your house. God will see to it that there is providence in your house. Masokaba suta leproso masotaba emosotiba. The Bible says, as they were worshiping, Elisha asked them to bring a musician. As the musician was playing, the word of the Lord came to Elisha. See, there's a word of the Lord for your situation. No matter what situation you are coming against right now, no matter where you find your life today, there's a word of the Lord. And the word of the Lord changes the direction you take. There is a word of the Lord. There's a word from the Lord. Hear me? No matter how hard you think it is, no matter how difficult, no matter how challenging, no matter how oppressing, no matter how mesmerizing your environment is, your circumstances, there is a word of God. There's a word from the Lord. There is a word from the Lord. There is a word from the Lord. Dekubaka. Shakaboto leposika. Malebroto brekula saku. Mako lepo sokiya pakote. Mado breko do prekuta kalesu leproto. There is a word of God. That word will come to you in the name of Jesus. I say you will not miss that prophetic word that will change. That will change the natural element, all of nature, the natural element, all the natural elements surrounding you. It changes nature. It changes the physical natural world. It changes it. The natural world. It changes it. Glory to God. And we find it as a reality, as a fact. It is a fact that God's word has power, that God can change, and God can bring, and God can resolve nature to advance his cause in your life. Elisha said to them, it's because of Jehoshaphat I'm going to do this. Ahab, I don't have time for you. As they were playing, God speaks. You see, God always speaks. I want you to have that in your system. God always speaks. God is not a quiet God. My father speaks. He talks more than anything in the world. He speaks. He has counsel for you. He has what you need. He has the things you're looking for. He knows how to get it to you. He knows where your spouse is right now to be. He knows where you need to get a job. He knows where you need to relocate to flourish. He knows how you need to get resources. He knows when you need. Oh my gosh. Jesus. For thus says the Lord. Thus says the Lord comes when you inquire of God in most instances. For thus says the Lord, you shall not see wind, nor shall you see rain, nor your yet the valley shall be filled with water, so that you, your cattle, and your animals may drink. And this is a simple matter in the sight of the Lord. Woo! I love that. That's one of my favorite scriptures. This is a simple matter. Begin to thank God that whatever situation you thought was complex, say over it, Lord, I inquire of you. Give me the solution, for it is a simple matter before you. This a tosika, whatever you're going through, this is your opportunity to get that prophetic word. Now it's your turn for you to talk to God. He speaks, he's going to speak to you directly. He's going to speak to your spirit man. He's going to give you a direction, because God gives direction. He told them, make this valley full of dishes. Verse 16. God instructs you what to do. It is obeying what you are instructed to do that brings your miracle. Your miracle does not come from heaven just falling like that. No, God speaks a word, you do something, and that triggers the miracle. Ah, yummy. All those of you children of the living God folding your hands and waiting for some magic to happen, God is not a magician. Your faith must work with his faith. You naposokata, pray maketiko, speak to me Father, and let me be instructed properly, and help me to know what to do. Grant me the wisdom and strength to know what to do. And as I do that which you want me to do, thank you for the providence. Masokotopo, masokotopo, maseketepo, masokotopo. Ah. Pray. Talk to God. That you are instructed. That is the best. That is the basis of instruction. That you must do something. You have to do something to activate your faith. Mm. Peter. Now, you've heard this testimony in the Bible, but God is going to give you a new revelation to it this morning. I'm so happy because it's going to enlighten your word. I mean, the word of God is sweet. It's going to enlighten your word. Question, children of God. Why was Jesus not too happy with Peter? When he asked Peter, of whom do the tax collector collect tax from? Is it from the children of the king or from the subject? What do you think? Why do you think that it was not too keen the way Peter responded to the situation? When Peter, you know the story very well, the fish, the golden fish. It's quite an illustrative miracle, right? I mean, that's one of the awesome miracles you can find in the Bible. Fish don't swallow gold. But Peter came and said, Master, first of all, the tax collectors went to Peter and said, Peter, why is it that your master does not pay tax? Peter said, oh yes, he pays tax. But that was not true. He hasn't paid tax. What Peter would have said was, I don't know. Let me go inquire of him. You see, the Lord was putting Peter in situations and places to see how Peter was going to, how inquisitive Peter is. Is he going to inquire of God? Or is he going to move by his own inquiry on his own? That's why they came. The Lord ordained it for them to come to Peter. And yet they have talked with Peter, and Peter presumptuously said, oh yes, my master paid tax. But the master has not paid. And the master was not meant to pay. He's the owner of the heavens and the earth. If they had come to Jesus directly, he would have answered them one question and they wouldn't have called that tax. They wouldn't have come to collect it. But they went to Peter looking for a means to bring discord in Peter's view of the master. So Peter, having spoken to them, was coming to Jesus. Before he could ask Jesus the question, Jesus asked Peter the question. And the reason for that question, if you look at that passage, let's look at that passage. You're going to be blessed. Oh, my Lord. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my Lord. That's a wonderful, 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 wonderful. Oh, yeah. Hmm. look at a scripture of it's very important. Why the question is that why was the father not so happy with Peter? He told Peter, says Peter, of whom do the tax collectors collect tax? Is it from the subject, from the prince? Is it the revelation there is that Peter should have told them, I don't have any idea, why don't you go talk to my master? When you come to a situation in your life that needs clarity, go to the master. Go to the master. Don't assume. Go to the master. Because the master has everything you need. The master has everything you need. So he's telling you, Peter, why are you anxious? Peter, why are you anxious? Peter, why are you anxious? God wants to transform you. Matthew chapter 7. Try and tell Peter. Of whom does the taskmasters, of whom do they collect tax? From strangers or from the children of God? Matthew chapter 7 from verse 24. Let's read. When they had come to Capernaum, those who received the temple tax came to Peter and said, does your teacher not pay the temple tax? He said, yes. Well, the teacher has not paid. He should have said, hold on, let me go inquire. You see, you must learn to inquire of God, although his mercy will sustain you. He said, yes. And when he had come into the house, Jesus anticipated him. Jesus knew what he had said. Jesus was not there, but Jesus sees all things. Jesus anticipated him. So Jesus said to him, saying, what do you think, Simon? From whom do the kings of the earth take custom or taxes? From their sons or from strangers? Peter said to him, from strangers. Jesus said to him, then their sons are free. Hallelujah. Akato. You see, when you learn to inquire of God, freedom becomes your way of life. You're no longer bound by the system of this world. Freedom and liberty becomes your reality.
Hallelujah.
Jesus. Nevertheless, somebody say nevertheless. Nevertheless, lest we offend them, go to the sea, cast in a hook, and take the fish that comes up first. And when you have opened its mouth, you will find a piece of money. I always say gold coin. It's not gold coin, actually. I've always been saying golden gold. No, it's the money, a piece of money. It's not gold, the real amount, the piece of money. Take and give it to them for me and you. Jesus. Someone said, this is an easy thing in the sight of God. Whatever problem you are going through, begin to speak to it. Say, hey, you are an easy thing. Father, you have given me the answer to this situation. You have told me and taught me and opened my eyes. You have instructed me to know what to do to overcome this dilemma. It is a challenge, not a problem. Therefore, I have the answer for every challenge. Somebody begin to pray this morning. It is an easy thing. It is an easy thing. It is an easy thing for my God. Talk to him this morning. Jesus have the answers for all your situation. Whatever you think you are going through, Jesus has the perfect answer for you. He has the perfect answer for you. My people, children of God, Jesus knows what. You just have to inquire of him. Once you inquire of the Lord, Masukana mama, opa sukapa, koraba baba, zokaba, oraba baba, oraba baba, solebo dobo. Mato karaba, ekorababa, goto kandoba debo, ekoraba baba, lepobo sikato bre, mosokita baba, lepoto prikanto bo, sokoraba baba, oraba baba baba, okaraba baba, koraba baba, zopa baba, sokanda keto de popopo, sakapoto prekato, lepopopo sikato prekanti. Not to hear from God is rebellion and witchcraft. Oh, now some of you are like, what? Am I in trouble? Oh, yes. It's not just normal for you to be an average Christian and say, I don't need to hear from God. I'm okay. No, you are not okay. You are the most dysfunctional person there is that does not hear from your father. You are disqualified when you cannot hear from your father. It means no good thing comes that in the life of that individual. Because how can you follow one that you don't hear from? My sheep, you read my voice. If you cannot hear his voice, you are not his sheep. So, Pastor, what do I do? Keep on asking by faith. Holy Ghost, I want you to speak to me. Get him involved in every aspect of your life. Don't remove even how you do your hair. Let him know. Should I put chemicals? Should I plait it? Should I go organic? Yeah, everything about your life, you need to ask him. Holy Spirit, what meal should I eat? Oh, say, Pastor, I don't eat it. It's just food. No. Then why do you bless the food before you eat it? Oh, it's going to be too rigid. Well, nothing is rigid. There's freedom. There's liberty. Hello. It's free. You're not paid to ask him. Father, where should I move to? What car should I get? I'm just like you. We never ask them. We just say, I like this. And you get what you like. But is that what was best for you? It is very important that you hearken to the voice of God. That if you are a child of God, you are led by the Spirit of God. See, it's in you. You have it. You don't have to stress yourself. Oh, can I hear your voice? It's always been there. You've not respected or let him. Just yield yourself. You have it. I'm not saying pray for him to give it to you. You have it already. It's in you the minute you were born again. Let me give you a good example. You are on this line today, not because just your friend gave you the number, because God, you heard the voice of God. God says, Dad. That's why you died. That's why you're a partner. That's why you pray. That same voice. I'm not talking about the new voice. That same voice that tells you die the conference line, join the prayer line. It's the same voice that leads you, that you must consult with. It's in you already. The reason God killed Saul was because Saul did not listen to him. You go, what? Oh, yes, God killed King Saul. 1 Chronicles chapter 10 to 14 tells you what happened. So Saul died for his unfaithfulness. You can never be faithful with God when you don't hear his voice. And it is a requirement when you want to walk with God that faithfulness is commitment on your part. The Bible says, and that is God's word, it is required in stewardship that a man be found faithful. In Timothy, it is required. It's a law, it's a requirement. It is required in stewardship that a man be found faithful. Stewardship means God has committed something for your upkeep, a talent, an ability, a family, a career, a commitment, a calling. You must prove to yourself a faithful steward. When God spoke to us 7.5 years ago to set up the prayer line or prayer city network, we believed God. We had to obey. There are hundreds of us. I mean, there are hundreds. We're huge. You're a large family. There are hundreds and hundreds of us on this line. Over the past 7.5 years. You must understand something. Is that we hear God's voice, so we obey God. You hear that same voice. It's in you. It speaks in you. And faithfulness is a requirement. When God asks us to do it, say, Lord, we are glad. We'll serve you, Lord. We'll be faithful with this calling. We'll be faithful with this calling. So Saul died for his unfaithfulness. Unfaithfulness ruins things. It destroys marriages. That's one thing that kills a love and will ruin a marriage at any time. If it can kill a marriage, it can kill a family, it can kill a business. Unfaithfulness ruins everything. It's betrayal of confidence. Are you faithful to God? So Saul died for his unfaithfulness, which he had committed against the Lord, because he did not keep the word of the Lord, and also because he consulted a medium for guidance. God gave him instructions, he never kept them, and also he was consulting medium, witch covens, witch doctors, psychic fortune for guidance. In life, you need guidance. You need to be guided in the right direction. But God's word and the voice of God, the Holy Spirit, is what you need. Whenever you feel you don't know what to do, then you look for a man of God that you connect with. Because the counsel lead you astray. That's why you yourself must know what God is saying. So God killed him. But he did not inquire of the Lord. That was the problem. Saul did not inquire of God for God to guide him. Therefore, he killed him and turned the kingdom over to David, the son of Jesse. Why did God turn the kingdom to David? Because God said, I have found a man after my heart. You are going to pray. Father, I am like you. Thank you for your heart in me. I yield today to inquire of you. Help me to grow in my inquiry of you. Help me, O Father, to become more dynamic in my inquiry of you. That I will know you more better. That I will know you more better. That I will come to appreciate you. Masoka Baba. Gato Bobo. Masoka. Ma Papa. Masokoto. The watchman said, the morning comes. And also the night, if you will inquire, return, come back. Isaiah 21 verse 12. The watchman said, the morning comes, and also the night, if you will inquire. God will speak to you day or night. He is faithful. kala bo 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 sotaba maso kala ba 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 ma pa ba 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 su maso toli pa ba soka ba 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 ora ba 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 su. God knows the future. He can tell you about the weeks ahead. Just ask him. Inquire about the end of the year. Inquire about the next year. He will tell you what to do. God is not limited. He cannot be limited. Inquire of him. He wants to show you the future. La popo po soka. Maso kante pro. Maso kante pro. Eko koko koko ko. La popo po po. Maso kante pro. Gabaso kante kim. Masoka e. Father, even as we come to conclusion on this series, we thank you for blessing us with this word. We thank you, O God, for the past 3 days or three times this week we've talked to the days of third part on how we can overcome the wiles of the devil. Lord, I pray, Father, for all your children on this line. I ask even those that will listen to this teaching on a future day, in a future year, whenever they come, let this covenant be activated in them, that we will hear your voice. That we will hear your voice. That we will be led by your spirit. Night and day, O God. That we will be led by your presence. That we will be led not by our own reasoning. Not by our own human understanding. But we will be led by your spirit. I pray, Father God, that we will learn to commit and inquire of you. In any activity, in everything that we do. That, Lord, will become a reality. It will be a reality, a reality, a real deal. It will be the real deal, the real thing, the real thing, the real thing, oh God. It will be the real thing, a reality in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we give you praise. We thank you, oh God, my Lord, that every tool that the enemy have used over the years to clog our ability to perceive, to clog our ability to be empowered, to clog our spiritual mind, is herewith broken. Is herewith broken. Is herewith broken. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, blessed be your name. Thank you for your mercies. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you for doing that which no man can do. Thank you for causing your glory, your grace to become a reality in us. We praise you, O God. We adore you. We adore you. We worship you. We magnify you, Holy Spirit, that you are our guide. You instruct us into all things. You teach us and we hear your voice. We hearken to you. We follow hard after you. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, this morning. Begin to bless him. Open your mouth and begin to bless him this morning. Begin to bless him this morning. Begin to bless him this morning. Begin to bless him this morning.